So we all know that surgery is the most effective tool to lose weight, but there are some basics which everyone should remember to stay on track. So let's revise them. Generally, after bariatric surgery, we don't advise you to count calories since the intake is very small. But this we are talking of later, the weight maintenance phase, maybe 2 years, 3 years, once the portion size have increased. And like Shikha mentioned, and some of you have also mentioned that how do we maintain weight? So first thing is you should know how many calories are you burning in the day. So you can find that out in three ways. In three ways the body is burning calories. 70% major part of is in your basal metabolism. So the calories you burn at rest. This is for different body functions like for circulation or for your respiration or the different cell functions. So even if you are at rest, 70% of the calories you are burning is because of your basal metabolism. And basal metabolism you can check on the machine. So when you come for the follow-up and we do the BCA, or you have machine at home to check your BMR, you can come to know your basal metabolism. Or I have mentioned this formula by which you can calculate roughly what is your basal metabolism. So basal metabolism, and then thermogenesis. In digestion of food also, one burns roughly around 10% calories. And you'll be happy to know that proteins are the most thermogenic food. So around 25% of the calories in protein are burned in during digestion of proteins. So suppose you are taking a shake of 100 calories, only 25 calories will be burnt in digestion of the protein. And in basal metabolism, I wanted to add that improving your muscle mass with strength training can improve your basal metabolism. And the third way in which we spend calories is related to the activity. So for an average person, the activity expense is around 10 to 20% of calories. So I've just enumerated different exercises light, medium and high, so that you have a rough idea of how many calories you are burning with physical activity. So walking, like slow walking of a minute, you can burn around 3.5 calories, and in half an hour it will be somewhere around 100 calories. With brisk walking in half an hour, you can burn almost double, up to 200 calories. So if you are doing an hour of light or medium exercises, you can burn 200 to 400 calories. So what should you do to maintain weight? Your calorie intake should be less than the calculated expenditure. So for intake, it's a good idea to keep a weighing scale in the kitchen, and maybe you can measure, you can weigh the food, the cooked food that you are eating. Because sometimes you are not very sure you had one idli, but actually how much it was. So it's a good idea to buy a weighing scale and start weighing the usual foods. Even if you weigh a bowl of dal, in your bowl once, you will know this is how many grams of cooked dal. And I have mentioned this link on MyFitnessPal. You can just enter all the foods you are eating in a meal, and it will show you, it will give you the nutrition information, how many calories, protein, carbs, and fats that food has. And there are many such, apps or websites or links on which you can find this information. But I find this very useful. So you will actually know, you know, how many calories you took in a meal, how much was protein, how much was carbs and all. So okay. This will help you to be more specific. And Dr. Goyal was mentioning that if you go, you know, to a non-bariatric dietitian, they may not actually focus so much on proteins.
Okay.
So these are the general bariatric nutrition guidelines for later as well. So initially, immediately after surgery, it may be difficult to have, you know, the desired amount of carbs. But gradually, as portions increase, you can, you know, include more of carbs in meals. So proteins, you already know, 60 to 80 grams per day. And if you're not taking protein supplements, you should really know well, you know, how much protein you are having in your meals. And carbs, you should take complex carbs, 50 to 130 grams in divided dose in the day. So we have discussed carbs in detail today. And 20 to 40 grams can be healthy fats, but you know, generally go for invisible fats. So nuts, seeds, avocado, olive, fish, you know, in case you are non-vegetarian, these are the better sources of healthy fats. So broadly, you should follow these, you know, nutrition guidelines. And surgery, understanding of how surgery works, patient management is constantly changing and improving. And as you know, we were mentioning during discussion that each person is different. You had different issues before surgery. Some of you have had different surgeries as well. And you have a different lifestyle. So, you know, it's better that we manage each one of you separately to be more specific. And interventions, lifestyle, we already know, behavioral modification where required, and follow-ups and appropriate medication will help. There are quite a few medicines which can help with weight loss as well. And this is Dr. Goyal's contribution to my presentation, which I really like, that, you know, we should all have it somewhere, you know, around in the kitchen. To eat is a necessity, but to eat intelligently is an art. And let's all of us, you know, try to formulate intelligent eating into our schedule.